Evening, ma'am.
Good evening. Am I audible to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Could you be able to see the slides?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Next, our topic is reproductive system. So we have the separate male reproductive system and female reproductive system. Okay. So today we are going to see about the female reproductive system. So in this picture, you can able to see, this is the female reproductive system. This whole female reproductive system is present in pelvic region. So below the abdomen, the whole region, we call it as pelvic region. In the pelvic region, we have this thing, ovaries. We call this as ovaries. Ovaries will actually release the ova. We call it as egg. So per month, one egg will be released by one ova. And this we call it as fallopian tube. And this is the uterus. And this is the vagina. So this is cervix actually. Cervix and this is vagina. So all together we call it as female reproductive system. So the female reproductive system will produce the ova from the ovary. And also it is the location for fertilization. Fertilization means fusing of male and female sperms. And also for the development of baby, and secretes the female sex hormones. The very important female sex hormones are estrogens and progesterone. And also it produces the milk to nourish the baby. So coming to the organs of female reproductive system, ovaries, fallopian tube, uterus, vagina, vulva, and breast. So coming into the topic, the combining forms are amnio. Amnio means amnion. So the baby in the womb is covered by two membranes. One membrane is amnion and other membrane is chorion. And cervico, which means neck or cervix. Chorio, which is chorion, the second layer of the fetal membrane. We call those two membranes as fetal membranes. Amnion and chorion. Colpo. Colpo means vagina. Clado. Clodi D sac. So clado is the part present inside the uterus. Embryo means the baby from the fertilization till the 9 weeks, the baby we call it as embryo. After 9 weeks till the birth, we call the baby as fetus. Epicio. Epicio means vulva. The whole external genitalia we call it as vulva. Feto means fetus. From 9 weeks till the delivery, we call the baby as fetus. Gynaeco means woman or female. So gynecology, study of women. Hymeno, which is the layer covering the vulva, we call it as hymen. Hystero means uterus. Lacto is milk. Mammo is breast. Masto is also breast. Meno is menses or menstruation. Metro means uterus. Nato. Nato means birth. So oophoro means ovary. So ovo is egg. Ovario means ovary. Perineo, which is perineum. Salpingo means fallopian tube or uterine tubes. Utero, which is uterus. Vagino, which means vagina. Vulvo means vulva. So coming to the suffixes, archi. Archi means beginning. Cysif is the state of pregnancy. And next, gravida is also pregnancy. Para means to bear the offsprings. Offsprings means to bear the live babies. Partum. Partum means childbirth. So postpartum means after childbirth. Prepartum is before childbirth. Salpings means fallopian tube. Tosia, labor or childbirth. So the female reproductive system will produce us the ova from the ovaries. And the site for the fertilization by fallopian tubes. So which is the most common site for fertilization. And uterus provide the location for the development of the fetus. And breast will nourish the infant. Through the breast, the milk will be supplied to the baby. And ovaries also produce female sexual hormones, estrogen and progesterone. So these are all will come inside the body. So what are all the organs present inside the body? We call it as internal genitalia. And what and all the organs outside the body, we call it as external genitalia. So internal genitalia are uterus, ovaries. So one uterus, two ovaries, two fallopian tubes and one vagina. These are all present inside the body. We call this as internal genitalia. So in this picture, you can able to see. So this is uterus, okay? Ovary, fallopian tube. So this whole region, we call it as pelvic region. So in the pelvic region, we have the urinary bladder, uterus and rectum. So here we have the ovary, and next this is the fallopian tube, and this is the uterus, and this is cervix and vagina. So here we have the vulva. So vulva, we call it as external genitalia, which is present outside the body. So external genitalia altogether we call it as vulva. In the vulva, we have labia majora, labia minora and clitoris. So the region between vagina and anus, we call it as perineum. So in this picture, you can able to see this region, we call it as perineum. So the region between, so the rectum and vagina, so this region. And ovaries. So ovaries are the two almond shaped glands. So which releases the ova for every 28 days. For every 28 days, one egg is released. And it also secretes female sex hormones. So this is the egg. So this is the ovary. So you can see the eggs. So for every month, one egg will get matured and it is released into the fallopian tube. Once the egg is going into the fallopian tube, there it will wait for the sperm. So when the sperm comes, the fertilization will happen in this fallopian tube. So these are the eggs. For every 28-day cycle, one egg will be released into the fallopian tube. And female sex hormones. So we have the four female sex hormones. Follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. So these two hormones are secreted by anterior pituitary. So to stimulate the ovulation and also for maturation of the egg. Estrogen and progesterone. These are produced by the ovary. This two hormones will prepare the endometrium. Endometrium means, I'll show you in the picture. So this is actually the uterus. The uterus is divided into three layers. Endometrium, myometrium and perimetrium. So the inner layer of the uterus, we call it as endometrium. So it will prepare the inner layer of the uterus for the baby. And also it promotes the female secondary sexual characters. Female secondary sexual characters means voice and body shape, the growth, hair growth, breast development, everything will come under female secondary sexual characters. This is actually the real picture of the ova. So this is the egg, which is released on every 28 days. Fallopian tubes. We also call it as uterine tubes or oviducts. So the purpose of it is, so that is the place where the fertilization will take place. So fertilization means meeting of sperm and ovum. So which is around 5.5 inch length. So it is from projects from the uterus till the side of the ovary. So these finger-like projections, we call it as fimbriae. And this is the egg released into the fallopian tube. So the process of releasing the egg, we call it as ovulation. So in this picture again, you can see. So this is the fallopian tube and this is the egg cell. And from it is released from the ovary. So the uterus. Uterus is actually the pear-shaped organ present in the center of the pelvic cavity. So we have three parts. So we have this fundus. So this part we call it as fundus. And this is corpus. Corpus means body. And this we call it as cervix. These are the three parts present in the uterus. And it also has three layers. So three layers are endometrium, myometrium and perimetrium. Endometrium are the inner layer. So here only the baby will get attached. Myometrium is the muscle layer which helps for the contraction during the delivery. And perimetrium is the outer layer and that is the thin layer. So in this picture, there was the very detailed picture. Ovary and this is the egg cell released. This is the fallopian tube. And here we have the blood vessels. And this we call it as uterus. Uterus is divided into three parts. Fundus, corpus and cervix. And the layers are endometrium, myometrium and perimetrium. And this we call it as body of the uterus. And this is the ovarian ligament, which makes the attachment of the ovary to the uterus. This is fimbriae. So these are the whole internal genitalia. Endometrium. which is the inner layer of the uterus. It contains very rich blood supply and it reacts to the estrogen and progesterone. So it usually thickens and receives the ovum. So fertilized egg I will actually implant here. It provides nourishment and protection for the embryo. And menstruation. So we call it as menstrual period. When pregnancy does not occur, endometrium will slough off. So what is a menstrual period is? The egg will wait in the fallopian tube for 24 to 48 hours for the sperm. If the sperm was not entered into the female genital, then the endometrium, the developed endometrium preparation will comes out of the body in a form of bleeding. So that we call it as menstrual period. So that will last for 5 days. So menarche means first menstrual period. Menopause means the last menstrual period. First menstrual period will take place between the age of 10 and 30. Menopause will be between the age of 45 to 50. And vagina. So you can see this is vagina. So the inner of the vagina is lined by mucous membrane. So it extends from the cervix till the outside the body. So we call this opening as vaginal orifice through which the menstrual flow will come out. And during intercourse, the male penis was received by the vagina and it serves as the birth canal because the baby will come out of the vagina. Hymen is the very thin membrane which covers this vaginal opening. And nearby the vagina, we have a gland called Bartholin glands that will produce the mucus during intercourse. So this is the vagina. And this is vaginal orifice. This layer, this orifice is actually covered by hymen membrane. And here we have the Bartholin glands. So that will produce the mucus for lubrication. And ulva. Ulva, we call it as external genitalia. In the ulva, we have labia majora and labia minora. These are the skin foldings. Those are protective foldings that also protects the urinary opening. And clitoris, we call it as erectile tissue, just like penis for males. So in this picture, you can able to see. This is clitoris. So this is urinary meatus. And we have the vaginal labia majora and labia minora. Breast. We also call it as mammary glands or lactiferous glands, which produces the milk. We also call it as lactation. So lactiferous ducts will carry the milk to the nipple. And areola is the region which is pigmented area. Pregnancy. What is pregnancy? So the gestation period. The period of pregnancy, we call it as gestation, which lasts from 40 weeks. So what is premature is? When the baby was born before this 40 weeks, before 37 weeks, we call that baby as premature. And embryo. From the implantation into the embryo until the 8 weeks, we call the baby as embryo only because the major organs and systems has to get formed. And fetus. 9th week until birth, when the organs mature and begin to function, then we call it as the fetus. An infant is surrounded by two membranes. One is amnion and other one is chorion. Amnion is the inner sac which holds the amniotic fluid in which the fetus will float. Chorion is the outer layer. Amnion is the inner layer of the baby. And chorion is the outer layer, so which is protective and which forms the part of placenta. So this is the fetus. So sorry, this is actually the embryo. Only the major organs will got developed. And surrounding the baby, we have the two membranes. One is amniotic layer and other one is chorionic layer. This we call it as placenta. And this is fetus. So after 9 weeks till the birth, we call the baby as fetus. So the development of the major organs will take place. And so placenta. So for nourishing the fetus, so which is a blood-filled organ present inside the, it is present inside next to the fetus, which we also call it as afterbirth, because when the baby was delivered, after delivered the baby, the placenta also will comes out after the delivery of the baby. So that's why we call it as afterbirth, and the placenta and the baby got attached with umbilical cord. So in this picture, you can able to see, this is the uterus. So inside the uterus, this is placenta. So placenta and the baby got connected with this umbilical cord. So and the baby will be floating in amniotic fluid. So coming to the stages of labor and delivery. First stage we call it as dilation stage. Initially, with the strong muscle contraction, after 38 weeks of pregnancy, with the strong muscle contraction of myometrium layer, the baby will be pushed towards the cervix. So in the effacement, the cervix will get opened. So it expands till 10 centimeters. In this picture, because this is dilation phase. So the baby will be pushed towards the cervix. And next, expulsion stage. So which is the second stage. So after fully dilation, the baby will be coming out through the cervix. So crowning means when the baby head appears first, then we call it as crowning. So in that case, they will go for normal delivery. So if the head is not appeared in crowning, then they will go with cesarean delivery. So on placental stage, which is the final stage, after delivering the baby, the placenta will be coming out. So once the baby got out, they will cut the umbilical cord and they will tie it. And later, they will pull the placenta also outside the uterus. And breech delivery. So normally, the crown of the head appears first in the birth canal. So and any other body parts appearing first, then we call it as breech presentation. Usually, the buttocks will come first. So coming to the word building part, amniotomy means incision into the amnion. Amniotic, pertaining or related to the amnion. Amniorrhea, any discharge or flow from the embryon. And cervicectomy, surgical removal of the cervix. Cervical, pertaining to the cervix. Endocervicitis, inflammation of inside the cervix. And chorionic, pertaining to the chorion. Colposcope, instrument used to view inside the vagina. Embryonic, pertaining to the embryo. Episiography, suturing of vulva. Fetal, pertaining to fetus. Gynecologist, which means female specialist. And hymenectomy, surgical removal of the hymen. Hysteropexy, surgical repair fixation of the uterus. We call it as hysteropexy. And next, hysterorexis, rupture of the uterus is hysterorexis. And lactic, pertaining to the milk. So lactic means milk. Lactoria means milk discharge. Laparotomy, incision into the abdomen. Laparoscope, which means instrument to view inside the abdomen. Scope means instrument. And mammogram, X-ray or record of the breast. Mammary, pertaining to the breast. Mammoplasty, surgical repair of the breast. Mastalgia, which means breast pain. Algia means pain. And mastitis, inflammation of the breast. Mastectomy, surgical removal of the breast. So coming to the meno, amenorrhea, means lack of menstrual flow. Dysmenorrhea, which is painful menstrual flow. Oligomenorrhea is scanty menstrual flow, which means little menstrual flow. Menorrhagia means rapid or very huge menstrual flow. Endometritis, inflammation within uterus. Perimetritis, inflammation around the uterus. Metrorrhea, which is flow from the uterus. And metrorrhagia, rapid flow from the uterus. Neonate, which means newborn. Neonatologist, specialist in newborn. Oophoritis, inflammation of the ovary. And ovarian, pertaining to the ovary. Salpingocytosis, which means fallopian tube pregnancy. And salpingectomy, surgical removal of the fallopian tube. Salpingitis, inflammation of the fallopian tube. And uterine, pertaining to the uterus. Vaginal, pertaining to the vagina. Vaginitis, inflammation of the vagina. And pseudocyesis. Pseudo means false. Cysis means pregnancy. So false pregnancy. Nulli gravida, no pregnancy. Primi gravida, which means first pregnancy. multi gravida means multiple pregnancies. Nulli para, no birth. So the person, the woman may be pregnant, but there is no birth. Primi para, first birth. Multi para, multiple births. Antipartum, which is before birth. Postpartum, which is after birth. Hematosalpings means blood present in the fallopian tube. And pyosalpings, pus present in the fallopian tube. And dystocia, difficult labor and childbirth. We call it as dystocia. Coming to the next. So, reproductive system vocabulary. So, ectresia, congenital lacking of body opening, we call it as ectresia. It's barrier contraception, which prevents the sperm from meeting the ovum. So, the condoms and diaphragms will be used. So, which we call it as contraception. So, that will prevent, so whoever is planning for the baby for delay, they are making it delay, they can go for condoms and diaphragms. Colostrum, the first milk coming out of the mother breast, we call it as colostrum. So that was the, before coming the actual milk, it will be watery in nature. Fraternal twins, so developing from two different ova, fertilized by two different sperms, we call it as fraternal twins. Maternal twins means they are identical twins. Fraternal twins are non-identical twins. They come from two different eggs and two different sperms. But identical twins come from one egg and one sperm. Gynecology, the diagnosis and treatment of diseases particularly related to female reproductive system. Hormonal contraception. So to prevent the pregnancy, they'll use the hormonal injections such as pills, patches and implants. Identical twins, developed from single ovum and single sperm. Infertility, which is unable to produce the children. No pregnancy after properly timed intercourse for 1 year. So after marriage, till 1 year, they are not getting pregnancy means there are chances of infertility. Intrauterine devices. This is also a type of contraception. In order to prevent the pregnancy, they will insert the devices into the uterus. Meconium, the first bowel movement of the newborn, we call it as meconium. That was actually dark green in color. Neonatology, the diagnosis and treatment of diseases of the newborn. Obstetrics, diagnosis and treatment of women during pregnancy and childbirth. Premenstrual syndrome, symptoms appear just prior to the menstrual period. So such as irritability, headache, tender breast and anxiety. Puberty, which is the beginning of menstruation of the reproductive years. We call it as puberty. And ovarian carcinoma, the cancer of the ovaries, which can spread to other organs also, which is highly dangerous. Ovarian cyst, so the water-filled bubbles, we call it as polycystic ovarian disease, PCOD. So usually these bubbles will rupture and causes the pain and bleeding. Cervical cancer. So malignant tumor, particularly to the cervix, means cancer to the cervix region. Endometrial cancer. So cancer to the inner lining of the uterus. Fibroid tumor. So there was the fibroid tumor present in the uterus. Menometorrhagia. Excessive bleeding during the menstrual periods. Prolapsed uterus. So we also call it as fallen uterus. So the cervix will protrude through the vaginal opening. These are the fibroids. So these we call it as fibroid tumors of the uterus. And next, candidiasis. So yeast infection of the mucous membrane. So the yeast infection of the vagina. Usually the vagina will get infection during the time of pregnancy. So they'll get the abnormal secretions from the vagina. Cystocele. When the bladder presses backwards on the vaginal wall, we call it as cystocele. Rectocele means when the rectum presses the vagina forward, then we call it as rectocele. And next, toxic shock syndrome, which is staphylococcus infection, usually comes from menstruating women. If they are wearing the tampons for longer duration, for 7 hours, 8 hours, usually if they go for sanitary pads, they may get this staphylococcal infection. Endometriosis, so occurs when the endometrial fluid tissue flows backwards from the uterus to the fallopian tube. Actually, it has to flow from the uterus to the vagina. But in this case, it will flow from the uterus to the fallopian tube. and into the pelvic cavity. And pelvic inflammatory disease, which is the bacterial infection that will spread through the female reproductive tract and out into the pelvic cavity. And breast cancer, the malignant tumor of the breast tissue, we call it as breast cancer. And fibrocystic breast disease, appearance of the fibroid tumors in the breast tissue. So there is no any association with the cancer. So we can see in this picture. So this is actually the tumor. And these are cysts. So that there was difference between the tumor and the cyst. So both can be easily, they can resolve it. If there is a tumor and cancer, then they will go with mastectomy, removal of the breast tissue. And the cyst also, they will resolve with tablets and injections. And coming to the pregnancy pathology, abruption placenta. So the before the delivery of baby, the placenta will come out. Usually the placenta has to come out after the delivery of the baby. But in abruption placenta, placenta will come out before the delivery of the baby. Next, eclampsia. Convulsions or coma seen in the woman at the time of delivery. Then we at the time of the delivery or the late stages of pregnancy, we call it as eclampsia. Nothing but fits. So they'll get fits usually. Hemolytic disease of the newborn. For example, if the mother is Rh negative and the father is Rh positive, then usually the babies will be Rh positive only because the positive is dominant than the negative. So then there are chances for the first baby to deliver safely. For the second, third and fourth baby, they have the baby will die usually without anti-antibodies. So if they take anti-antibodies, then the second baby, third baby can come normally. So that we call it as hemolytic disease of newborn. Placenta previa. Usually placenta will be above the baby. But in this placenta previa, placenta will be very near to the cervix. Then it leads to abruption placenta. Means the placenta will come first. So for these patients, they will advise complete bed rest. Pre-eclampsia, which is metabolic disease of pregnancy. We call it as true eclampsia. The mother will have hypertension, headaches, edema. We also call it as toxemia. And this is placenta previa. So the placenta will be placed nearby the cervix. And prolapsed umbilical cord. If the umbilical cord emerges from the birth canal before the baby, just like abruption placenta, if the umbilical cord comes first, so it will be pinched between the head and the vaginal wall. So it cuts off the blood flow of the baby. In this case, the mother has to go for immediate C-section. Spontaneous abortion, which is an unplanned pregnancy, so which comes in the early gestation, which is very common. So they will have the abortion at the early stages. During first few weeks of pregnancy, we call it as spontaneous abortion. And stillbirth. So the death of the fetus of the viable age, which occurs shortly before or at the time of delivery. And coming to the clinical laboratory test, pap smear. Pap smear is the test done particularly for the cervical cancer. They will remove the cells from the cervix and they will test whether the person is having any cervical cancer or not. Pregnancy test. Usually nowadays the pregnancy test was very easy. So we will be having the tester for the pregnancy if they put urine. So in the urine, if there is HCG hormone, then the pregnancy will be positive. If the urine, they don't have the HCG, then the pregnancy will be negative. Hematosalpingography. Taking an X-ray of fallopian tubes after injecting a dye into the cervix. Mammography. Taking an X-ray of the breast for detecting the breast cancer. Pelvic ultrasonography. They'll use the ultrasound waves to take an image of the pelvic, so which is usually done for the pregnancy woman is pelvic ultrasonography. Colposcopy. Examining the vagina with using the instrument called colposcope. Cladoscopy. For the examination of the pelvic cavity, that too behind the uterus with using the instrument cladoscope. So they will introduce the instrument from the vaginal wall only. Laparoscopy. So laparoscopy was done by cutting the abdomen and inserting the laparoscope instrument through the cut, and which is done below the navel. So this is laparoscope. So with the help of this instrument, this is ovary. This is fallopian tube. This is uterus. and amniocentesis, the removal of the amnial fluid with the help of needle to see the fetal maturity, development, or any genetic disorders. Apgar score, immediately after delivery, they will see the baby for heart rate, respiratory rate, color of the baby, muscle tone, and they will rate it and they will put the reading. So according to that, they will know whether the baby is in the good condition or not. So Apgar score is very, very important. Chorionic villus sampling. So the removal of small piece of chorion for genetic analysis, we call it as chorionic villus sampling. Fetal monitoring. Usually this is an electronic equipment. So they'll put on the mother's abdomen or on the fetal scalp to check the heart rate during the delivery and the labor. Cervical biopsy. Removing a piece of cervical tissue to examine for cervical cancer. Endometrial biopsy. Removing a piece of endometrial tissue to examine the cancer. Pelvic examination. Physical examination of vagina and the adjacent organs. So usually they'll use one instrument called speculum. So this is speculum. So this is used to open the vagina. So after opening the vagina, then they'll see the internal pelvic organs. And C-section. Surgical delivery of the baby through the abdominal incision, we call it a C-section. Conization, removal of core of cervical tissue. And dilation and cartilage. So dilation of cervix and scraping away of the endometrial lining. We call it as dilation and cartilage. And next, episiotomy. Incision of the perineum and widening the birth canal. Lumpectomy, surgical removal of the breast lumps. So which is immediately so done. And simple mastectomy, removing of a breast tissue. Radical mastectomy means they will remove the breast tissue. Along with the breast tissue, they will remove some of the chest muscles and axillary lymph nodes. Elective abortion, which is the legal termination of early pregnancy. Huggies. Amazon. Amazon. Elective abortion. So, which is the legal termination of early pregnancy. The therapeutic abortion is termination of pregnancy with concerning about the health of the mother. And next, total abdominal hysterectomy, bilateral salpingo-oophorectomy. They will remove the entire internal genitalia. They will remove the uterus, cervix, fallopian tubes, and both the ovaries through the abdominal cut. So if there is any cancer of the uterus, if there is any cancer with the ovaries, they will remove the entire internal genitalia. And vaginal hysterectomy, removal of uterus through vagina rather than an abdominal incision. And tubal ligation, which is surgical typing, so tying off of the fallopian tube to prevent the contraception, which is a family planning surgery. And coming to the pharmacology. Arbortifacient is to terminate the pregnancy, which promotes the abortion. And fertility drugs, which usually triggers the ovulation. And hormone replacement therapy, that usually replaces the hormones called estrogen after menopause. So after menopause or loss of ovaries. Oral contraceptive pills, this usually will prevent the pregnancy. So, and also blocks the ovulation, which is usually they'll take the hormonal pills that we call it as oral contraceptive pills. Oxytocin, when the woman is not getting the pregnancy pains at the time after completion of 40 weeks of gestation, then they will give this injection, oxytocin. Then immediately the mother will get the pregnancy pains. So coming to the abbreviations, AB, which means abortion. AI, artificial insemination. BSC, breast self-examination. CS, which means cesarean section. CVS, chorionic villus sampling. And CX means cervix. DNC, dilation and cartilage. And EDC, estimated date of confinement, which is the estimated date of delivery. EMB, endometrial biopsy. ERT, estrogen replacement therapy. FEKG, fetal electrocardiogram. FHR, fetal heart rate. FHT, fetal heart tone. FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, FTND, full term normal delivery, and GRAV1 is which is first pregnancy, gynec, which is gynecology, and HCG, human chorionic gonadotropin, HTN, hemolytic disease of newborn, HPV, human papilloma virus, HRT, hormone replacement therapy, HSG, hysterosalpingography, and IUD, which means intrauterine devices, and next IVF, in vitro fertilization, or test tube baby, LBW, low birth weight, and LH, luteinizing hormone, LMP, last menstrual period, NB, which means newborn, OB, obstetrics, OCP, oral contraceptives, and PAP means papillo test, which is done for cervical cancer, PARA, which is first birth, PID, pelvic inflammatory disease, PMS, premenstrual syndrome, and total abdominal hysterectomy, bilateral salpingo oophorectomy.